John McDonagh.
Michael McDonagh.
Oh, for fuck's sake, mate.
It looks better in widescreen. That's why I have it.
Maybe you should keep that to yourself.
Francis Coppola said you should never trust a man with three names.
Did he?
Yes, I always feel like it's fair warning.
And who's he?
Francis Ford Coppola.
Never heard of him.
He had three names. He did Apocalypse Now, The Godfather.
What, just because I'm Irish, you don't think I know who Francis
Ford... No, just because it's you.
Yeah. I notice, actually, that you're always chipping away at our insecurities, because in your film, there was a character, and on the basis of him being Irish, you said he wouldn't be familiar with Japanese literature.
With UK,
and on behalf of all
Irish
people,
jibe.
Go fuck yourself.
It's a cheap jibe. I just thought, you know, there's so many gags about everybody else, the Japanese, Muslims, whatever.
But we're much more sensitive than, because we're so desperate for to be perceived as, you know, people who know how to have a good time.
Right.
Very insecure.
Right.
Did you know that about Irish? Well, you're Irish.
I mean, you're Irish. There is an insecurity about specifically, let's say, Irish films, how they're perceived by the rest of the world.
Well, Irish
especially
films,
especially the Americans.
Yeah, they're shit. Irish films are fucking horrific. I fucking hate everybody.
Just because you're not getting enough work, is that it?
Oh, I can't get work. Do you know what I mean?
Okay.
But there are some good Irish films, but there's so many bad ones that the good ones are marred with that sort of.
Which then has an effect on the audiences, because then they don't want to. They're like, ugh.
But you didn't need to say that your film was not Irish or was Irish, because it just spoke for itself.
I'm not a nationalistic person, so I'm sort of against all that kind of, it's an Irish film, it's an English film, it's this, that, or the other. But because cinema, it's great, it's world cinema, isn't it? It's not, I don't care if a film's from South Korea or whatever, it's irrelevant.
What was also interesting in your film, about the primary colours, it was the same in The Guard and it was in Calvary.
Yeah.
You have a lot of the background with just a big block of red. And it's actually very enjoyable.
I was a big admirer of Pedro Almodovar, and he uses a lot of primary colours in his movies. And the American director, Nicholas Ray, you know, like Red Without a Cause, big reds, big splashes of red all the time. And it just works well visually, so I kind of kept doing it.
Even your dress here, you're all about your primary colours, John Michael McDonagh. You love your primary colours. What the fuck's all that about?
Well, it was a coincidence. I just noticed yesterday that I was wearing a red top and it matched the red on the title, so I thought I'd wear it again. That was the only reason.
That is quite gay of you. Have you had sex with a man?
No.
You hesitated.
Not full coition.
Right. I notice you and your brother, you have a very predatorial look. You have these eyes that are like, you're figuring out my weakness. And you're going to pounce. And you do that, I think, through your work.
Right.
Would you like to kill someone? Have you
ever? No, not really.
Again, normal people would just go, absolutely not. But there was a long hesitation.
Well, I mean, Nabokov said a murderer is always inferior to his victim.
Well, he was a cunt. And, sorry, there was something else I was going to ask you.
Refer to your notes.
I'm going to refer to my... I have notes, mate.
Oh, wow, you've got loads.
Yeah, I do, yeah.
Oh, well done.
Yeah, Skarsgård, hunchy.
Right.
See? Having a go at the Irish. You're always having a go at the Irish. But you are Irish. I mean, you know, even though you were born in London.
Yeah, London Irish, yeah.
Yeah, but you look like a big farmer. And you look like you eat well.
But I've lost like 24 pounds.
Yeah, not enough.
So that's how big I was.
So what is it about filmmaking that you hate?
It's too much work. That's the main thing. I mean, it's well paid. But I just, you know, I became a writer, so I didn't have to get up early in the morning. And as a filmmaker, you're always getting up early in the morning. So it was like defeated the purpose of becoming a writer in the first place. But then I only became a director to protect the writing. You know, if that makes sense. So I kind of have fallen into being a director. I would have much preferred to be like a lazy screenwriter.
So is this the last film you're going to make for a while?
Well, there's usually a couple of years between films. I mean, generally speaking, I'm being a bit facetious, but obviously you eventually get bored and you feel like you should do something. I tell you what, the thing about working, though, is, what I noticed, is that you start... I would dwell on death all the time when I'm not working. So I guess that's the only good thing about work, is it takes your mind off death.
So you have an unhealthy
obsession.
Relationship.
I find the older you get, the more you think about death.
Yeah, I find the opposite.
Really?
When I was younger, I was more obsessed with death.
Right. I've been quite lucky with my health, against all odds.
Yeah, well, you're a well-built man, tough guy. Like, yeah. If you and me were in prison, I think I would be your...
Would you subdue me, or would I subdue you?
I don't know. It would be horrifying.
or really loving.
Who has got a bigger penis, you or your brother?
I've never measured them.
It's so competitive. I've never measured them?
We've never measured each other's penises, no. You're like thinking, I bet they did or something.
Well, you're so competitive. It is a bit of...
We must have done it at some point.
Well, no, but I mean, it is like who's got the bigger cock, who's more successful, who's got a... But and do you reckon you have a bigger penis than mine?
I would assume.
Yeah. Interesting. War on Everyone.
It's a good title, I think. It's a memorable title.
We have to wrap up. Would you like to say to your prospective audience, I mean, first of all, The Guard was the biggest grossing box office film in Ireland ever.
Independent Irish film, yeah.
Ever.
And it still hasn't been topped.
War on Everyone. Everybody's looking forward to seeing this film. I saw it. It's fantastic. What would you like to say to your audience?
Well, it's kind of a deliberate reaction against Calvary. So it's a straightforward laugh-out-loud comedy. And it's kind of like The Guard had one kind of dodgy anarchic cop, and this has two. So it's kind of a crass commercial doubling down on The Guard, basically.
John Michael McDonagh.
David McSavage.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
You had a nice swim, honey?
My eyes hurt.
You put too much chlorine in that pool.
He's been up to something.
No, I haven't.
All innocent little Lord fucking Fauntleroy over here.
Let's go fuck some scumbags.
Get the hell off this property. What are you doing?
Oh, no. Get back, you little bastard!
What are you doing?
Fuck off.
You fuck off. You fuck off. You fuck off. You fuck off.